So let's talk about the Northern Adriatic, or the Adriatic altogether. So it is a very special place in many ways. Just looking at the different coastlines, you got Italy on one side, you got Slovenia, Croatia, later Albania, and of course Montenegro in between. And those coastlines are already distinctly different from each other. So in Italy, if you love sand beaches, that's the place to go. The Croatian coastline, look around, it's all rock shore. Now, this means it's a stable substrate and lots of algae can grow on it, which is a good thing, very much the opposite of what many people believe. And that again is a rich biodiverse environment for lots of fishes, lots of other marine animals. So that alone makes a huge difference and gives a massive biodiversity to the Adriatic and the entire Mediterranean altogether. And while the Mediterranean is already one of the richest environments in terms of marine biodiversity, the Adriatic is tipping it off even a little bit higher. Now, one of the downsides of the Adriatic though is that these days lots of migrants coming from the south. So migrants not being people in that case, we're actually talking about intruders from tropical waters, for example the Red Sea, that find their way into the Mediterranean and then ultimately on the long run of course also up the Adriatic Sea. That again means that as the water is getting warmer, other species tend to migrate north where the water is a little bit colder, and then at some point they hit Monfalcone, which is the northern dead end of the Adriatic, and that's where they can't go any further. Now that is only the very, very rough outline, but we were lucky enough to come across a few people on our way to east where we are right now, who can tell you actually a little bit more about the Adriatic, simply because they also spend a lot more time here, basically half their lives, or some of them even their entire lives. So let's hear from them.
During our stop in Pula, we had a chance to talk to Gerwin. He founded a marine research station in Pula more than 20 years ago, and has become a good friend since. He was willing to share some of his insights and experiences that he collected over the course of many years in the Northern Adriatic.
If you ask me about this nice sea we have here, the Northern Adriatic, the north of the Northern Adriatic Sea, I got impressed from this really special sea before nearly 40 years. And in this span of 30 to 40 years, I permanently was here, exactly here, and I watched how everything changes and develops. How the people changes, how the country changed, and it is unbelievable change here. I would say it is crazy what the last years went on here. I would say in the last 2, 3, 4, 5 years, the change is so rapidly, it is really crazy. And the longer we wait, the faster is this change. So every season we have from month to month something really incredible happening here in the sea. It begins with weather conditions. So at the beginning, when we started our marine biology courses in the year 2000, it was constantly like that we started really snorkeling in June, because before it was absolutely too cold, and we stopped end of September because in October it was stormy, cloudy, wet, it was incredible, impossible to work. And the last years, it is constantly like this, that October is one of the best months here. It is so nice, calm sea, it is warm water. So the season was prolonged, the warming of the weather. So this is the one point. The second is we check such strong weather appearance here. It is sometimes frightening. So every summer we have now storms. Also the local people agreed in this. They are living here till they were born, and so they really know the difference. But during summer we have storms you usually have in winter. The permanent warming is obviously because we cannot feel it in the water, because it's just 1 degree in 5 years or 10 years or maybe 20 years, medium fluctuations of 1 degree per year, so we cannot feel it. But the organisms of the sea are really depend on constantly temperatures, because they are not adapted to strong temperature fluctuations till the ocean exists. And so such kind of warming we cannot feel, but it changes whole ecosystem, and this we can watch. So every year there are some new species here in our bay or around here that never any human has seen before, because they love warmer conditions. So they are mostly in the Dalmatian Sea, in the South Adriatic, or in the Mediterranean, East Mediterranean, or even in the Red Sea.
So these were some of the insights from the area of Istria. Some other friends of ours have spent even more time in the Adriatic. They have basically spent their entire life in the Croatian islands and traveled to many other parts of the world. And while the changes are also visible elsewhere, there is of course also good things we can all witness.
I've been around in different seas, and Adriatic always brings people, and in people's minds it's Adriatic, it's a clean sea, transparent sea, you can see beautiful colors, you can see through the sea. So one thing that always it's connected to the Adriatic, it's the clear water of the Adriatic. The other one would be the quite abundant sea and full of biodiversity. Still, it's going down. There is many things going downside, but let's talk good side first. Adriatic Sea, it's interesting sea also because it has three different, let's say, depths. It's a enclosed sea of the Mediterranean, and it's also, you would think that it's enclosed, so it's more salty, let's say, but salinity it's weaker than in the rest of the Med, because the Adriatic Sea has a lot of fresh water coming in. So especially on the Italy side, the River Po and other rivers are giving a lot of and nutrients in. That's why it's quite rich. And the north of the Adriatic is quite shallow, 50 meters, and then the part that it's distinguishing the Adriatic and the Ionian Sea, there the depths go down to 1,200 meters, I think, 1,233, they say. Adriatic Sea also, it varies in temperatures. It's quite cold in the winter, let's say in 12 degrees, it's kind of an average, maybe south is 13, 14, 15 max, but it goes down to 12, even less in the north. And summers are 30, up to 30 degrees. Okay, 30, I said maybe too much, it's almost tropical. But 28, 27, it gets here easy. So the summers are beautiful for a swim to stay long, and the winters are colder and empty, because also the fish and everything, the whole sea life almost moves to the deeper waters under the thermocline, because there it's constant kind of a 14 degrees, and the sea life always goes there because can always freeze. The surface, so in the winter it's quite empty and everything is quite deep, the sea level. The lifestyle, the islands, it has a lot of islands, mostly in Croatia. More than 1,000 islands, even not even 70, 80 are inhabited, I would say. So a lot of islets, rocks, kind of a protected biodiversity. It was full on rich in the monk seals before, but now monk seals all moved down south to Greece because tourism is full on in Croatia. So they don't have, even on those small islands, you don't have that privacy and just living the nature as it is anymore. So it's quite busy. So many tourists and people are coming that even though we protected that area, there is so much pressure happening from the people that the wildlife is moving away. There is still the disturbance of the people in the area, so the wildlife is moving away. The tourism should help, but it needs to be way differently regulated than it is now. Seagrass is the lungs of the Mediterranean. So there is a kind of a part to push for the protections and no-take zones, but you know how it is.
Seagrass in the Adriatic Sea, even so from locals, they don't have a good relationship. Well, we figured out recently, they don't have a real attachment to the seagrass, which is the lungs of the Adriatic Sea. So when those students, you know, those researchers, they went to interview the locals, and even the locals, oh, what is your relationship to the seagrass? Oh, when I was a kid, I was afraid of this black patch, so, you know, I wouldn't dare to swim on top of the patch because I was afraid. So, yeah, there's a bit of a lack of education about their sea.
Adriatic Sea and Croatia coast and the islands, they're mostly based on a small-scale fishing and the fishermen are living from it, and it's not like over-exploiting the sea that much as the big guys, as the pure seiners and trawlers and so on. Tourism is driving people to live, in a way. So, before it was, I will catch, I will go, I will have for myself or the village a little bit so they can be sustainable and a really small scale. Because that was also always the Jacques Cousteau saying, if everybody would catch the fish for themselves, there would always be the fish in the sea. But now it's, if we are just selling and looking at through the profit and for the tourists and so on, because tourists want to have fish, then the fish declines. So the fishermen are not, they can be destructive, the small-scale fishermen.
But we cannot blame them for...
We can't blame them as well, yes, mm-hmm. Because they do need, this is their way of life and they learn how to. So we should support those more than the big ones. But the money goes to supporting, the fund subsidies goes to mostly for the big guys, pure seiners and the big technologies and the big quantities, because it's more outcome at the end of our income, and this is for everybody all there is. Yeah, so yeah, small scale can be, even if now they wouldn't be the big guys, the small scale wouldn't make an impact. But now the big guys take so much that the small scalers do need to stop in the spawning season, and minimum catch size for everybody, that would be a huge difference. And by the way, this was before Croatia entered the EU. We had this regulation of spawning seasons for specific fish and minimum catch size, but when we entered the EU, we needed to reduce by the EU laws, and then we can change it later.
For me, as a foreigner, because I am not Croatian, I've been only being here for the last 4 years or so, I found that the coast is not so overpopulated like in other countries, by locals, I mean. Tourist season, yeah, in the summer. But then I found that the people are quite close to each other, let's say. maybe the locals won't have the same opinion as I do, but I think that people are quite united than in other places.
People here still know how to live on an easier pace than people on the mainland, where they're running from one spot to another. We need to do this, we need to do that. So here people are more
laid back
a little bit and enjoying the present moment, enjoying that sea, enjoying the view, enjoying the talk, enjoying the food, enjoying...
Because it's true that the peak season is in the summer, definitely. And the rest of the year they are enjoying a little bit of time off, because it's quite intense, must say, in the summer. And they enjoy some time together. They are still sticking around.
But it can be tough sometimes on the island. Where we are on Tres, it's not island as such, but on some smaller islands, it can be tougher winter for less people.
But in this sense, I think the islanders are sticking more together than coast continental.
Yes. Okay, yeah.
So here is what we can take away. The Adriatic Sea is special and pristine in many ways. With more than 1,000 islands, the amount of coastline is amazing. And with a diverse structure of the coastline, from sand in Italy to the rocky shores on the eastern coast, the base for huge biodiversity is already there. One thing that did become very clear though, is that things are rapidly changing in the Adriatic. The water gets warmer, climate and seasons are shifting, and the input of various materials is becoming an increasingly big issue. These include plastic and byproducts of agriculture, but also the sheer amount of tourism that is taking a toll on the ecosystem. However, the locals pace their lives, even though in many cases they revolve around the touristic season, especially along the coast. They are somewhat united and work together. We also learned that the local, small-scale fishermen are usually not the issue, but the big catching fleets, that basically empty the seas, are also the ones who get subsidies from the government and EU. And on top of that, some good regulations that were already in place had to be taken down in order to comply with EU regulations. All in all, we can say, there is a variety of issues to be tackled and lots of work to be done. But being such a pristine place, it sure is worth giving it the extra care that it deserves.
Now that the Adriatic is the playground for many of the tourists from Austria, from Germany, from all over Europe really. Oh, now you learned a little bit more about it, and maybe the next time you come back on a holiday, you might dive in with a whole different appreciation of all the beautiful things you see. So I hope you learned a little bit more about the Adriatic Sea or the Mediterranean and the marine environment altogether. And tune back in about 2 weeks when the next video of this length will come up. So until then, see you soon. If you like what you see, please have a look at our website www.projectmanaia.at. You can find out a lot more about the work that we are doing on the run. And also you can find a way to support our videos and support our course. Since we are all funded by donations, it would help us out a lot. If you do want to share the video with your friends, please do so on social media, Facebook, Instagram, whatever floats your boat. And yeah, see you next time. Bye-bye.